Welcome to the live stream of WCW NWO Revenge for Nintendo 64. This is Ron Moore, and the last time I streamed this game, I had to cut it slightly short because I had to get going, and so I didn't quite get to finish the long freaking 40-man Battle Royal, but that's okay. We're going to do it again here tonight. Let the CPU go at it on the hardest difficulty. Just do a chill stream. All right, I'll get started here with the game in just a second. Hopefully you guys are doing ECW tonight. No, on Trovo it says the category is Fire Pro Wrestling, but they don't have the option to pick Revenge on there, at least not yet. Love this intro here. I always thought this intro was pretty cool. Got this game around the same time I got Ocarina of Time. 98 was an awesome year for games. Thank you. There's Zbysko.
Well, you know, Tony, you gotta be aggressive.
Ming, one of the most legit tough guys ever in the history of the business and history of the world. Probably heard a lot of stories about this guy. Ming's legit.
Well, you've got to be aggressive, Tony. With 20 glorious years.
Here we go. Thank you. Oh, Kevin Nash. Weird looking move, but he beat him with it. DDP. Ooh, Nash is busted open. Oh, and he's out of there. Man, Zbyszko ain't playing around tonight.
Well, like I said, you gotta be aggressive.
Zbyszko's still in there from the beginning. Is that submission from Zbyszko? Yep, he got him. Oh man, nice double team there to get rid of Van Hammer. Here comes Chavo Guerrero. Thank you. give it up to Zabisco, man. He lasted in there for a while. Here comes Aki, man. Hey, British Steel, how's it going? That is Aki Man. He's the custom-made character by THQ. Aki was one of the companies that collabed with THQ to make this game. That's Aki Man. Reminds me of Blitzkrieg. I like Chavo's shirt there from Eddie Guerrero. Cheat to win. And DDP tapped out. He didn't want none of that. Like a knockoff of Karnov and Iron Sheik. Give DiMolinko his move back. Get rid of kimchi is annoying. Giant looks funny in this game. ECW package. Man, somebody get rid of him. Sick boy, jeez. He's out. Yes, Roddy Piper. Come on, Papa, get rid of Kim Chi. Not Piper, not already. Sub-Zero. Yeah, get rid of him. Sick boy, what are you doing? I remember all that hype they made for Glacier. They hyped him up for months, and he makes his debut on WCW Pro Wrestling. And he becomes a jobber. Like, what the heck was that all about? I mean, he didn't job on that show. He won his first few matches for a while. Oh, good. Finally got rid of Kim Chi. Oh, here comes the Barbarian, Ming's tag team partner. Yeah, it was like he was getting a decent push at first. He had a cool entrance, no pun intended, but after a while he became a heel and became like, you know, a jobber, and then, yeah, it was ridiculous, dude. That big hype they made of him, all those promos, coming soon, Blood Runs Cold, dun dun dun, and Glacier, coming soon. Then he becomes like this, just, you know, nothing but hype. Oh, sick boy, about to do a special here. Sounds like a, ooh, bust him open. looks like a mix between Stevie Ray Slapjack and Triple H's pedigree. A slapjack, sucker! Exactly, yeah, I remember the demon, Dale Torborg, the Kiss demon. Being a useless jobber, had that stupid storyline with Vampiro and Asia and the graveyard match. No, it was Sting. Was it Sting and Vampiro in the graveyard match? And I don't know if the, or I think the demon also fought Vampiro in that match. And it was, I don't even remember, dude. It was so stupid. Yeah, the demon, Dale Torborg, just, you know, built him up to be this big thing, and then he's nobody, much just like Glacier. But Glacier was hyped up even more because they were, for months and months, they were hyping up Glacier. I don't know if like he got injured for real and they pushed back his debut or what, but I remember forever they kept on promoting Glacier, these promos, Glacier coming soon. I was like, when? I also remember the No Limit Soldiers and Big Swole and whoever else was in that group was wrestling for a while, and I mean, that probably just a, I don't know if that was a one-time thing they were doing or what, but I don't know. I remember that, Master P and the No Limit Soldiers, WCW in the summer of 99. Glacier's out, here comes Rey Mysterio. I remember that Junkyard Hardcore match they had in Bash at the Beach 99. Some wrestlers got injured for real. I think Fit Finley was one of them. Yeah, he looked like Mortal Kombat 3 Sub-Zero. That's right, Glacier. I think Russo was gone. No, Russo hadn't showed up yet. That was Bischoff, actually, believe it or not. Russo had not shown up yet. If you're talking about the No Limit Soldiers and the Kiss Demon, Kiss Stealing, Willing Dealing, son of a, whatever his name was called. Yeah, no, that was, Russo was not in the company yet. Yeah, Bischoff was still there in charge at the time. This is like 2 months, around 2 or 3 months before Bischoff was fired. Thank you. I think Russo was worse. I mean, he had, you know, Russo was only good because Vince McMahon was the filter in the WWE. At least Bischoff, I mean, granted he stole the invasion angle, NWO angle from Japan, but at the same time, Bischoff, you know, while he wasn't perfect, he still wasn't nearly as bad as Russo was. Russo just, even Bischoff was like, dude, what are you doing? Russo just came up with so many ridiculous ideas. And some of them were good, but a lot, most of them were bad. And WCW, you know, Russo did not have that filter in WCW like he did with Vince McMahon and the WWE. And yeah, Russo, I think, was worse. Ooh, that was nice. Ooh, the Giants busted open. John just shrugged that off. Oh, he almost got him right there. Thank you. Oh, he's got a special, but he's not going for the chokeslam here. Not wasted. For those of you following me on YouTube, tomorrow night, 7 p.m. Central Time, I will be streaming WWF No Mercy on Nintendo 64. Tomorrow night, 7 p.m. Central Time. Ooh, he almost got him. And the giant hanging in there. Ah, Mysterio is out. It looks like a knockoff of Butt Bagwell. Looks like the Outsider's Edge. Man, the Giant gets eliminated by that Buff Bagwell knockoff. Here comes Bischoff now. Bischoff's like, yeah, what's up? Come on, what's up? That's what's up. That was a sick clothesline by Sick Boy. It'd be funny if Russo was in this game. Came out, started fighting with Bischoff. Yeah, that's right. He was a part of the AWA before he was with WCW. He actually applied for an interview job, the interviewer job with the WWE, and they had him practice with a mop or a broomstick or something. It's ridiculous. Bischoff did not get hired, so we got hired in WCW instead. What are you doing? Jeez, it worked though. Jeez, Lodi, my least favorite wrestler of all time. Get him out of here. What is a Lodi? We'll get a Lodi this. We got fake Buff Bagwell in there and some ninja or reject for Ninja Gaiden and then Conan. Conan's pretty cool. Tequila Sunrise, ECW Sunrise. Oh, Conan, there we go. Lodi was with Raven's Flock. He sucked. Shogun is a custom-made character from THQ. Rakowski is as well. Lodi was just terrible. His gimmick was stupid. He just held up signs. He was like the equivalent of Sign Guy Dudley in ECW. He was just annoying. At least Lodi is not as annoying in the ring right here like Kim Chi is with Ah, oh, Conan, come on. Yes, Rick Steiner. I loved the Steiner brothers. Yeah, give her. Oh, wait. Yes, there we go. All right, Lodi did something right. Ooh, bust him up in the process. Lodi saying, I'll show you something. Disco Inferno, I like this guy because he was funny. Do you remember Stevie Richards, his entrance music? I'll show you, you'll see, you'll see, you'll see. Thank you. Yeah, Rick Steiner. Yeah, unfortunately, Scott Steiner, not anymore. And that's probably good for the sake of his health, because he was so juiced up for so long, and he almost died not too long ago. But, yeah, man, I remember Scott Steiner was a freak. Oh, no, Scott Steiner no more. He lost a lot of muscle mass recently because he had that health scare where he almost died not too long ago. I don't know about Rick Steiner. Scott Steiner, though, I saw recent pictures of him. He wasn't not muscular anymore. Knee drop him on his foot. What are you doing, Shogun? Lodi is out of there. Nice, La Parca, the chairman of WCW. Ooh. I'd like to see him versus Balls Mahoney in a chair match. Yeah, I remember that. Thankfully, he survived. Oh, nice. Here goes Michael Jackson. I mean, Juventud Guerrero. There's Halloween season. Apropos of that, the park is in there. Oh, dang, Rick Steiner's out of there. Oh, here goes Dr. Frank. Halloween characters coming out now. Remember Mortis and Wrath? I remember that stupid match between Juventud Guerrero and Reese from Raven's Flock, another reject. He's in this game too. Thank you. It's like a Castlevania 64 enemy. The chainsaw god that chases you in that garden maze in the Villa Mansion. Remember the Yeti? And it was also played by Reese, one of the Raven's Flock rejects. Stole Lex Luger's torture rack and made him tap out to it. There he is. Yeah, old Tommy anime character. Thank you. White Thunder, Scott Steiner. Remember that? I like that old WCW set right there in the background. Better than that new one they had in 99 and then 2000. I love that set right there. He goes, oh yeah, gets attacked from behind. Macho Man with the Wolfpack, I remember that. Riggs, I'm getting too old for this, Riggs. This game is rigged. Yeah, how's it feel? Tap out, Frank. Oh, there he is, Fit Finlay. My name is Finlay, and I love to fight. I remember when he broke Steven Regal's nose for real. In a Clash of the Champions pay-per-view, I was at Super Brawl 6. It's like it broke his nose. You could hear the smack and everything. So, oh, man. Thank you. I wish Bam Bam Bigelow and Ric Flair were in this game, but Bigelow was not in the company yet, and Flair was like having that lawsuit with Bischoff before he came back. I was about to say, sick boy. Ah, he did! Riggs, LeMay, Scott Steiner. You gotta be kidding me. This game is rigged. The British Bulldog now. Riggs trying to look like Big Boss. They should have put the Shockmaster in this game. Yeah, he was in 93 for a short period, but right here, yeah, he was also in 97 when Bret Hart left the WWE, came WCW, and along with Jim Neville Neidhart, yep, Bulldog joined him. Elbow on his back. Well, make up your mind, Macho Man. He still got the pin, jeez. Stevie Ray, sucker. Chris Jericho. They all gang up on Jericho. They don't like him. Man, he's looking at my phone. Who got eliminated? Jericho got eliminated already? Jeez. I remember that feud he had with Di Malenko in that Lucha Libre Battle Royal. Cruiserweight Battle Royal, and then Dean Malenko was in disguise as Cyclope, and man, that was an awesome moment. Jericho got mad. This is a conspiracy! Going to Supreme Court and everything, trying to appeal that. I'm a conspiracy victim! Who eliminated Jericho? I didn't see that. Exactly. In my opinion, the greatest technical wrestler of all time. Oh, the side of the head. I remember Dean Malenko's James Bond gimmick just right before he retired. I thought it was cool, but then he retired. I was like, dang it. not so much a James Bond secret agent gimmick, but like a ladies man James Bond type gimmick. He had the entrance music similar to a James Bond-esque type music, and like he thought, you know, he's like a ladies man, and he had that little angle with Lita. ECW style. Yokozuna, Hawk Hana. That's it, we got the final three right here. He's done with Bulldog, leave him alone. And Bulldog, I don't know, I think Riggs must have stole something from Bulldog. He's still getting up slowly. He can still eliminate people though, he can still pull people out of the ring, which I think is cheap or should not count, but that's how the game is. Oh, he was fresh too, but it's not over. He could get revenge. Bulldog, get out of the way. Bulldog, what are you doing? You both of y'all asking to get eliminated. Get away from the... See, you idiot. Executioner wins. Jeez. ECW. All right, guys, gonna take a 10-minute intermission. I'll be right back.
Thank you.
All right, we are back. Let's go. See Goldberg destroy Bischoff here. Going out with Elizabeth. He busted open Goldberg already. I like Goldberg, and here comes the pain. He was a beast in that game. Can't believe Bischoff's not busted open yet. Goldberg going to the top turnbuckle? Dude, do your spear and jackhammer. I remember the feud between Flair and Bischoff. Be knocked out. And I was getting up. Bischoff still hanging in there. Ooh. I want to see the Zbyszko and Bischoff match at Starrcade. There's Zbyszko. Well, you know, Tony, you got to be aggressive in this business. I mean, living legend. have Bret Hart in there as a special referee. I like this music. That taunt. He's putting him all these submission holds just like he did the real match. Ooh, he's busted wide open. I think he beat him faster than Goldberg did. Scott Norton was a beast. decent. This music too. There's the old Halloween Havoc 97 logo. Thank you. And almost got him. Got him. I like it when Piper pokes people in the eye. The way he does it is so funny. Hey, yo, Chico, how's it going, Hitman? Going ECW? Oh no, hate to hear that, man. Not ECW Zombie. What about Zombie CW JLT1 or LJT1? Dr. Death, German suplex. Yeah, I know you're talking about. Yeah, they cut that promo. Oh, Scorpion Death Drop. Hogan no sells it. Nice Flair's move. We'll be right back. Do something, Bischoff, with your cheap jacket. Wait a minute. No, yeah, be careful, Hitman. A little bit excessive. Emotes. Yeah, Nightbot. Well, I did on YouTube. I guess I didn't on Twitch. But at the same time, that I guess I can see that as being a little bit excessive. Yeah, I see it in the restream chat, but not in the OBS chat room here, the Streamlabs chat. Ran to that big boot. I remember Super Brawl 8 right here. That's a pretty good pay-per-view. That was when Scott Steiner turned heel, turned on his brother and joined the NWO. I remember Halloween Havoc 97, Eddie Guerrero, Rey Mysterio. Awesome freaking match. Here we go, Scorpion Death Drop again. I didn't hear about that rumor. Man, Hogan got him. Oh, wow, I didn't hear about that. Speaking of, let's do that match right now. Like Eddie's shirt, cheat to win.
ECW.
Let's go. I'm not sure, man. I liked Eddie Guerrero's WCW music. It's freaking awesome. test of ECW again. I also remember Juicing Thunder Liger. I wish he was in this game when he wrestled Rey Mysterio at Starrcade 96. He almost got him there for real already. This match ain't gonna be as epic as the real one, but oh well. Man, he got him there. He beat him in this match, though. It was rumored for Mysterio to lose in the real match, but he lost the one here. Yeah, here we go. Saturn got big booted out of the ring. Oh, dude, they even flow. Wasted. Got him. I know we've done seen Sting and Hogan already, but I want to see them again, this time in the Starrcade Arena, in the Starrcade match. I know that match wasn't the greatest, but I personally liked it because I loved it when Sting beat Hogan. I'm such a huge Sting fan at the time. That's going to be the last match of the night. Hogan doing an enziguri kick, get out of here. Thank you. What are you doing? You could have done the Scorpion Death Drop there. That command yet on Twitch. Hello, Tiz. I'm gonna beat Hogan at Starrcade. Not here. Dang, Hogan almost beat him again. Go. ECW. He's out. Alright guys, thank you very much for watching the stream and chilling. Tomorrow night I will be streaming on YouTube with WWF No Mercy. Hopefully I will see you guys there. If not, I'll see you around some other time on Twitch, DLive and Trovo. And see you guys later. Hope you guys have a great night. I'm Ron Moore. God bless and take care.